It's a harrowing story. A woman was driving for Uber on Friday night in Grand Junction when police say her passenger, 23-year-old Adam Salas, pulled out a gun and demanded she take him to the desert. The victim jumped from the car while it was still in motion to escape. As the car crashed into a fence, detectives say Salas got into the driver's seat and sped away. The victim had minor injuries. GJPD issued a warrant and Salas was picked up last night more than 600 miles away in Carlsbad, New Mexico.
That's amazing she could actually think on the spot that fast.
Tammy Joyce has been a Denver-based Uber driver for the past 2 years, completing more than 5,000 rides.
On the weekends, I drive till 3 or 4 in the morning.
Tammy says only a handful of her passengers have ever made her nervous, but adds most of the female Uber drivers she knows choose not to drive at night.
Let's face it, men are bigger than us, and most of them sit in the back seat.
Uber recently implemented new safety technology, creating an in-app emergency button that connects riders or drivers directly to 911.
You hit the button and then you hit it again and it calls 911 for you.
Uber also added Ride Check, where the app can detect if you veered off course or took an unexpected long stop. Another is called Follow My Ride.
You can share your location and trip status with your family or friends to make sure you're safe.
But they wouldn't know if something was going wrong inside the car, necessarily.
Not necessarily.
Bottom line, Tammy wants drivers to be in tune with who you let into your car. And remember, you do have a right to refuse any ride.
And this year, Uber plans to expand its sexual misconduct and assault training and education for all of its U.S. drivers. Meanwhile, the suspect in this case remains behind bars, being held without bond. Live in Denver, Kristen Hobrick, Fox 31.
Kristen, thank you.